Okay, so I will talk about floating point representation for decimal numbers. Okay, the floating point representation will always be written as some number m multiplied by 10 to the power e. Okay, this particular m carries the name mantissa, and e is called the exponent. Okay, so let's take this particular number 2.5134. So 2.5134 in this kind of representation will be represented, let's say, as 2.5134 into 10 to the power 0. Okay, so this particular number is 2.5134. Now we can also represent this number as 25.134 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 1. We can also represent this as 0.25134 multiplied by 10 to the power 1. Now the question is, which of these representations is correct? Okay, now when we are talking about, you know, doing things by humans, all these representations mean one and the same thing. You can interchangeably use any of this representation and you know really what that particular representation means and you can do your calculations. However, when you are going to use a floating point representation, we require certain ways of representing the numbers that is uniform and that is standard over various different types of machines. Okay, so the standard that is used in floating point representation is that this mantissa should necessarily lie between 1 divided by 10 and 1 for decimal systems. Okay, again I am taking some pedagogical liberties over here, so please bear with me and I will try to summarize all of this after I finish explaining the floating point representation. So with this particular definition that m lies between 0.1 and 1, the correct representation of our number is going to be this. Okay, so instead of having a binary computer, if we had a decimal computer, the floating point number 2.5134 would be represented as 0.25134 multiplied by 10 to the power 1. Any number in our decimal computer is going to be represented as 0.... So we have 5 blanks over here. Okay, so we are using 5 digit mantissa. Okay, multiplied by 10 to the power dash. Okay, so we are using 1 digit exponent. Okay, in order to not complicate things, we will just look at the positive values of exponent. We will only look at the positive values of mantissa. Okay, the reason is because in binary notations, for example, you will use a sign bit in order to determine the sign of the entire number, and you will use a signed way of representing the exponent. We will come to that later, but let us just assume for the time being, for the sake of simplicity, that we are only going to represent positive numbers with positive exponent. Okay, so what do actually these 5 blanks really mean? This blank really means that this particular number is multiplied by 10 to the power minus 1, just the way we had it in the binary notations of the integers. Likewise, the decimal notation of the mantissa is this guy multiplied by 10 to the power minus 1, this multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2, and so on. So when we have the 5 digit representation 25134, this actually means 2 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 1 plus 5 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2 and so on, which will give us 0.25134. Okay, keep in mind that our decimal computer is not going to waste any space in representing this 0 dot. It is only going to represent this 5 numbers. The first digit is going to be multiplied by 10 to the power minus 1, second digit 10 to the power minus 2, third digit 10 to the power minus 3, so on and so forth. Okay. Now let us say that this one, this is the kind of representation we are going to use. Okay. So the first, the number that we can represent, the 2.5134, the way we will represent is, as we said, is 0.25134 multiplied by 10 to the power 1. Okay. The number 2.5135, we will represent that as 0 point, and again I am putting this in a bracket because in our decimal computer we are not going to spend any waste any space in representing the 0 point. The next number will be represented as 0.25135 into 10 to the power 1. Okay. Now let us say we had a number between these two numbers, let us take that number as 2.1345. The question is, how do we represent 2.51345? Is if we try to do that, we will have 0.25134, and now we have run out of space to represent that particular number. So what is happening over here is, if we have said we are going to save 5 spaces to represent the mantissa and 1 space to represent, excuse me, to represent the exponent, we will not be able to represent a number 2.51345. Okay. So this, you will either be able to represent that as 0.25134 into 10 to the power 1, or you will be representing this as 0.25135 into 10 to the power 1. You will not be able to represent one more digit over here. Okay. Now what we will try to do in our decimal computer is, we will use what is known as chopping off. Okay. What we mean by this is, for example, if I give you a number, say 2.51347, okay, and I tell you that I want you to just give me 5 significant digits for this particular number, you will give the number as 2.5135. Why? Because you are rounding off this number. What a computer, what our decimal computer will do, it will just throw away this number. This number is just discarded off, and any number between 2.5134 and 2.5135 will be represented as 2.5134 itself, because we are discarding all the numbers or chopping off all the numbers. Okay. So to summarize, if we have represented a decimal number through using 5 digit mantissa and 1 digit exponent, okay, we can at most represent the number of the form 2.5134 or 2.5135. We cannot represent any number between those two numbers. Okay. That is what is known as a finite precision. So coming back to what we were talking about, or where we got started off from, we got started off from talking about errors, and we said there are two types of errors, truncation error and round off error. The round off error comes up because a finite precision machine is chopping off the numbers beyond what it is capable or what you have asked it to store. You have asked it to store a real number using only 5 decimal digits. As a result of this, anything that requires a 6th decimal digit is going to be chopped off. So what I want you to do is just think about, you have the representation 0.5 digit mantissa multiplied by 10 to the power 1 digit exponent. Okay, think about what is the largest number you can represent using this particular notation, and what's the smallest number that you can represent using this particular notation. Okay, so the various possible answers that people had come up with, the largest number, actually I think most of the people got it right. The largest number that you can represent is going to be 0.99999, because those are the largest numbers each placeholder can hold, multiplied by 10 to the power 9. Okay, this is the largest real number that our floating point representation is going to hold. Now, what's going to be the smallest real number? Okay, the smallest real number is going to be 0.00001 multiplied by 10 to the power 0. Okay, that's the smallest real positive number that can be represented. Okay, if you wrote this as your answer, unfortunately your answer is incorrect. The reason why this is incorrect is, remember what we said about the mantissa. The mantissa will lie between 0.1 and 1. Okay, keep in mind there is an equality sign over here, there is no equality sign over here, right? The largest number that is represented by the mantissa is 0.99999 and not 1.0. 1.0, remember, would be represented as 0.1 multiplied by 10 to the power 1. Okay, so the mantissa lies between 0.1, less than and equal to mantissa, less than 1. So this particular number will not be represented in this way. This particular number has to be represented as 0.1000 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4. Okay, now the requirement we said with respect to the exponent is, we said we did not want to represent negative exponents over here. Okay, so this particular number is not admissible in our scheme of things, in our decimal computer. So the smallest number that is actually admissible in our decimal computer is going to be 0.10000 into 10 to the power 0. That is the smallest positive real number. Okay, so the largest positive real number was 0.99999 into 10 to the power 9. The smallest positive real number is 0.10000 into 10 to the power 0. Okay, keep in mind that we are going to use all the 5 digits. So that means the number is not 0.1 into 10 to the power 0, the number is 0.10000 into 10 to the power 0. Okay, now if we relax our assumption of only positive exponents and to say that even the negative exponents are admissible. Okay, so let's say that the exponents that are possible will range from, say, minus 9 to plus 9. Okay, this is again for the argument's sake, and there would not be a necessarily a representation in the decimal system. The reason is because we need one storage for this particular negative number, and if we are going to use a decimal digit in order to do this storage, it is going to be a waste of a lot of space. Okay, so this is perhaps not something that we would want to do in the decimal system. Okay, but let us say, for argument's sake for now, just that the exponent that is allowed is from minus 9 to 9. In that particular case, the smallest positive real number, if the exponents were allowed from minus 9 to plus 9, is going to be 0.10000 to 10 to the power minus 9. Okay. So the crux of the matter is that the smallest and the largest real numbers are actually determined through through what your exponent is. The exponent determines smallest and largest real numbers that can be represented using our floating point notation. Okay. Now, as I said, the use of number minus 9 to plus 9 is very wasteful. So, now if you want to admit negative exponent also using a single digit, what can we possibly do? Well, one thing that we can possibly do in order to admit positive and negative numbers also is the exponent we will represent, rather than saying e is the exponent, we will actually say exponent is actually e minus some constant. And let us use for this particular constant 10 divided by 2 equal to 5. Okay. So, again from where we have gone from trying to represent this number 2.5134 in our decimal computer to we talked about how the mantissa and the exponent is going to be represented, and then we talked about how the representation of the exponent can be wasteful, and now we are going to talk about how we can admit both the negative values of exponent and the positive values of exponent. Okay. So, again now what we have over here based on this particular redefinition is, instead of defining our number as m into 10 to the power e, if we were to use this particular definition, we are going to represent this as m multiplied by 10 to the power e minus 5. Okay. So, when we have this particular representation, we have 5 digits to store the mantissa, 1 digit to store the exponent. The exponent e, the value of e, the admissible values of e are 0, 1, 2 and so on up to 9. As a result, the admissible values of exponent become minus 5, minus 4, minus 3 and so on up to plus 4. Okay. So, this revised definition of our floating point representation has the smallest positive number as 0.10000 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 5. This with the 6 decimal digits that we are going to use in our computer is going to be represented as 100000. Okay. This is m, this is e, and our representation is m multiplied by 10 to the power e minus 5. Okay. So, that is the smallest positive number. The largest positive number is going to be represented as 999999. So, this represents 0.999999 into 10 to the power 9 minus 5 or 10 to the power 4.